Hey everybody, good to see you all again. In our last Nvidia video, we talked about how there was a report from a company called The Information that stated that Nvidia might be having some trouble due to Blackwell delays. And we said that Nvidia is going to be just fine. Make sure you check that video out. We'll link that right here in this video. And the other video that you should check out before watching this one is regarding the AI bubble. We talked about how so many analysts are pumping this idea that we're in an AI bubble that is going to pop soon. So those two videos, make sure you check them out. Very important to our discussion here today. And we're going to be discussing a possible next revenue driver for NVIDIA in this video, besides data center accelerated compute.
Before talking about this next potential AI product hit, just a high level overview here. NVIDIA, historically a fabless chip designer, a big holder of IP, of patents that it can license out to a lot of other companies. But in recent years, especially moving into the tech equipment and devices, like you said, Casey, for data centers, accelerated computing systems, and enterprise software. And this has built NVIDIA into just an absolute industry juggernaut. It can address virtually every single end market there is for semiconductors these days. And of course, that AI infrastructure, accelerated computing infrastructure more broadly, possibly in max growth mode right now. But today, let's focus on those other segments, especially that one right below, consumer products, PC and laptops for NVIDIA, and cloud and enterprise. Okay, before we jump into that, quick reminder, everybody, you may have seen it in some of our recent videos, our sponsor, Moomoo. If you are a new Moomoo user, remember by the end of August, August 31st, you still have a few weeks to grab those 20 free stocks and up to 8.1% APY on your uninvested cash. That is a chipstock investor exclusive. Make sure you check out the link to that in the description below, as well as in our channel bio. Again, up to 20 free stocks. All you have to do is be a new Moomoo app user and deposit at least $1,000 into the account, and you get that 20 free stock bonus. Not a bad little deal.
We had some good buys this month that we wanted to take advantage with our new Moomoo account. With NVIDIA, everyone is focused on the data center in their revenue segments, and for good reason. You can see that data center makes up the largest portion of their revenue segments. In Q1 fiscal year 2025, this most recent quarter, over $22 billion in revenue.
Yeah, a big deal indeed. That's about 80% of revenue in the most recent quarter. And given that that segment was just a mere $4.3 billion in sales a year ago, going from $4.3 billion to $22.5 billion in a year, kind of unprecedented. And the bulk of those sales are going to the big tech giants. So we've been discussing this over on our Discord channel, which you can get access to via Semi Insider. Check the link to our Ko-fi shop below for that. But big tech, you can see, again, this goes into what you were mentioning before, Casey, about the AI bubble. It's not really an AI bubble. This is just general capital expenditure or CapEx for data center updates. You can see Google historically still well within the normal range of CapEx spend on NVIDIA equipment and data center equipment in general. Microsoft might be a bit of a different story, but remember historically, Microsoft is a software business. And in the last decade, they have aggressively been building out Azure, their cloud infrastructure service, to compete with Amazon AWS. So that's the reason for the elevated CapEx for Microsoft. Capital expenditures are kind of a newer thing for them. And then in Meta, AKA Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp, it kind of really took to Google's business model years ago. And unbeknownst to most people, it's not just simply a social media business. It is one of the world's most powerful data center computing companies, but you can see also well within historical norms, or at least in the last, five to 10 years, still within historical norms for their CapEx on data centers as well. that's where NVIDIA is picking up all of those sales.
What about gaming? Historically, gaming was synonymous with NVIDIA. This is where they made all of their money. The GPU, the graphics processing unit, was NVIDIA. You can see that the revenue declined and then it has leveled out in the most recent quarters. You can see that it's only 10% of the overall revenue.
So Casey, we had a little bit of our own personal hardware upgrade cycle that we went through in the last 6 months or so. Your little RTX 4000 series laptop could be about to get outdated though, perhaps here in the fourth quarter of 2024. Why is that?
Yep, looks like it's time to upgrade once again. The Blackwell-based RTX 5000 could be launching in late 2024. So that's going to make my 4070 look pretty out of date.
Yeah, now we don't know the specific architecture specifications, but we can assume that the new RTX 5000s could be based on Blackwell and probably going to obliterate the Lovelace architecture that the 4000 series is based on. One of my devices is still running on an RTX 2000 series. I am definitely in need of an upgrade. So it could be just the good old-fashioned gaming segment that provides some nice uplift for NVIDIA in the next couple of years. But this is where we wanted to actually spend the majority of our time on this video: professional visualization. A very small segment, but you can see on a year-over-year basis, some significant growth from this segment. Well, let's talk about what this ProViz segment is and why this could be NVIDIA's next billion-dollar plus per quarter segment.
Regarding professional visualization, NVIDIA said that it was up 45% from a year ago and down 8% from the previous quarter. Now, when you think of professional visualization, this isn't my laptop. This is for professionals that are doing much more than a YouTube channel video editing. This is for professional filmmakers, engineers, architects. These are workstations outside of gaming or with a personal computer or laptop.
Yeah. I wouldn't be so sure. I'm pretty sure your laptop purchase probably got bundled into this segment earlier this year, but who's counting? Also interesting in this segment is NVIDIA Omniverse cloud APIs. So you probably by now for the last few years heard CEO Jensen Huang talk about digital twins, industrial AI, the next industrial revolution, all of these fuzzy words surrounding new types of AI, new use cases for artificial intelligence coming to the real world. This is actually, besides just the actual ProViz workstations, this is simply a software service that is now being bundled into this revenue segment. We don't know how big a part of the ProViz revenue segment that NVIDIA Omniverse is, but we think it's going to get quite large. Several years ago, when they debuted Omniverse to the public for public use, NVIDIA has been using Omniverse since the pandemic lockdowns. It was something that they developed and used themselves to help get work done when they weren't at the brand new shiny headquarters in Santa Clara. But this could very well be headed towards just the software segment itself could very well be headed towards a multi-billion dollar per year revenue line over time. So SIGGRAPH presentation a couple of weeks ago, Jensen talked about the need for three AI computers. The first is creating or training the AI. That's that data center segment that everyone's focused on. The second is simulating and refining the AI. And then the third is running the AI. And that could be, if you're a professional, a workstation from the ProViz segment. But what about this middle layer, the stimulating and refining the AI? What is that?
This slide is from Amazon, but you can see that we've added a little bit of detail to help understand exactly what the AI life cycle is, so to speak. It starts with data, raw data. A computer has to scrape that data for various types of information, and then it's trained on that specific data. But what we're focusing on is building applications after you have scraped the data and then trained the AI to understand what that data means. What are we going to do with it exactly? That's the building the applications portion of it. That's where Omniverse Enterprise comes in, because it's a software that can actually use that data, that AI training, to build out applications.
Yeah, and the software service is built using OpenUSD or Universal Scene Description. So this is very much rooted in NVIDIA's legacy as a graphics processing unit developer for the video game industry. It requires an RTX powered workstation in order to use Omniverse. But then that workstation kind of ties into this Omniverse cloud-based software service. And that costs $4,500 per year for each GPU that you rent in the cloud. So again, what we're historically talking about with this ProViz segment are those, the sale of those workstations, the actual laptops and PCs, and you know, the external computing units themselves that might be sitting on someone's desk or sitting in an office that people are using. But the software itself, that newer portion of ProViz, $4,500 per year for a cloud-based virtual GPU. NVIDIA provides this little demonstration of what that software looks like. It's much like an LLM model that maybe you've interacted with, like ChatGPT. You put an input in and outputs something on the right-hand side of the user interface.
Yes, there is a lot of applications that this Omniverse software can be used for. In this slide, you can see it's being used to simulate the world around a vehicle. When you have a driver assist system, the vehicle can understand what exactly it's sensing. Or maybe you're trying to design your perfect Nissan Z. You can configure your car with this software and down to every last detail and see exactly what it looks like. So the first two, I can definitely see some application for. What am I looking at here? This looks a little iRobot-esque.
Yeah, it definitely does. This one is listed as reinforcement learning. So perhaps there's a robotics company. Maybe it's like a humanoid robot, like shown in the picture here. Maybe it's not. The next slide shows an alternative use for robotics, but maybe it's just not practical to build a bunch of these things in the real world. And so you can actually do some of your reinforcement learning to help teach these things how to behave virtually. You can build a virtual three-dimensional world, drop your robot's software system into the 3D world, and then simulate what it does and reinforce the behavior that you want it to exhibit. And maybe human robots isn't your thing. Maybe the thought of having your own personal assistant make you toast in the morning kind of freaks you out. Well, there's for applications for robotics as well with this reinforcement learning and with training. Maybe it's simply building out a warehouse for logistics and delivery. So like Amazon pulling boxes off of shelves and getting them out the door for delivery.
And this one I find particularly interesting. This is a visual from their digital twin software. Companies can build not only the outside portion of the factory, but like the placement of every single piece of equipment that's going into that factory before they break ground on this. This seems like a very valuable tool for cost efficiency, for time efficiency, of seeing this all placed in there before you even break ground.
Absolutely. A few years ago, when we were doing some digging into the metaverse, remember when that was a thing, when that was a hot term, this is what we landed on as the first and most important use case for the metaverse. Not actual, being able to hang out with each other in a virtual world, but creating these virtual worlds before they actually get built in real life. This is tremendous. If you're a manufacturer, there's a lot of automakers that are using Omniverse to reconfigure different layouts. Semiconductor manufacturers are using this to reconfigure layouts and build new manufacturing lines. So all of this is ultimately to say, this is what we think could be an underrated growth market for NVIDIA AI.
Yeah, it absolutely could. And while everyone is focused on the data center, including us, because that is the largest revenue driver for NVIDIA. NVIDIA is not just a data center company, just like it wasn't just a gaming company. They're a well-diversified company with their hands in all sorts of the market in the semiconductor space. And they also have a fantastic software stack to go along with it. So we expect to see some growth in these segments besides data center in the coming years.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And this is something the whole semi industry and really the whole world of technology has centered on is, okay, right now we're in this phase where data centers, accelerated computing infrastructure is all the rage. But eventually, if that is going to get put into broader use, you need more devices that can handle this AI, and you need software that can make it useful for as many people as possible. So that's where we see the gaming and ProViz segments coming into play in the coming years.
So you're going to do it. We're going to talk about valuation for NVIDIA. That's dangerous.
That's why I put "for what it's worth" on this chart title.
Okay. So for what it's worth, forward price to earnings, right around 40x, and price to free cash flow on a forward basis, 45x. So Nick, is it time to buy NVIDIA?
Well, we thought it was a good buy the dip opportunity here the last couple of weeks. And so that's what we did. We talked about this over again on our Discord channel. Check out Semi Insider. We've been discussing this quite a bit. All valuations are subjective, especially with this one. No one has any idea how big NVIDIA's AI accelerated computing segments are going to get. And we don't know how long the cycle is going to last. All indications are that this thing will keep chugging higher through calendar year 2025, more than the valuation itself. Now, you know, the valuation does matter. Obviously, it got a bit stretched there at over 40x, 1 year forward expected price to earnings. There in late July, we had the pretty significant pullback from 40, 50, 50 times forward valuation. So an elevated valuation like that is going to cause increased volatility, always will, even for NVIDIA. But the more important thing to focus on, in our opinion at this point, isn't so much the valuation, but keeping a very, very close eye on signs that the accelerated compute cycle is maybe losing some steam, or maybe headed for a temporary cyclical downturn at some point in the future. So for what it's worth, there's our take on valuation. We thought it was a decent little nibble on the recent pullback.
And so far, it's been a good decision. So we'll see how that continues. We have NVIDIA earnings coming up in just two more weeks. We'll have a live Q&A session over on our Discord channel after NVIDIA earnings as well. So make sure you check that out, and Semiconductor Insider, as well as those 20 free stocks on Moomoo. Link is in the description. We'll be back with more here at Chipstock Investor. Hope you have a great week, and we'll see you soon.